Hey everybody and welcome. In one of the last videos I did, I showed you how to measure your black bear skull using just some things you had around the house. And what we used was a couple soda cans and some post-it notes. Now, BNC, Pope and Young, they don't use pop cans and post-it notes to measure. They use calipers. So to test how close we were with that last way, I went ahead and went on Amazon, and for $15, I bought a set of calipers right here. And we're going to use these, just like Pope and Young or BNC would, to measure this skull and see how close we were. So just as a quick recap, the measurements we're going to take is the farthest point front to back, which is a line straight through the skull, and the farthest point left to right, straight through the skull. So those are the two measurements we're going to take, and we're going to add those together to come up with a score. Once again, we're going to remove the lower jaw because it is not needed. It is not a point that's wider or longer. And so I'm going to take our calipers and find our points here. We're going to go right off that front tooth and then right off this farthest point in the back. And right there, we're touching on both. So we're going to take that. These are tension calipers, so they stay where they were. And then we're going to come up to our measuring stick here, and we're going to go right to the 1 foot mark to make this easier to do math-wise. And we're going to line that up right there and right there. And we are right at 11 and a half inches. So we're going to write down our first measurement of 11 and a half. That also should be written 11 and 8 sixteenths is what it should be written, because black bear skulls are scored to the 16th. All right, now we're going to take our width measurement. See where we get here. Find our widest point. I think we're right. There we are, we're right there. Oop. A little bit more. All right, so right there is our widest point. Take that. We're gonna come back here to the 1 foot mark, lay that on there, and lay this on here. And we are 6 1/2 and 1/16 is where we're at. Do this one more time, make sure that that's right. Yep, 6 1/2 and 1/16, or 6 9/16. Write that down. All right, now we're going to add these together. 11 1/2 plus 6 1/2. So that's 10, 6, 7, 8, 1. So 18 inches. And add that extra 16th. So what we found out is that this skull is 18 inches and 1/16. That's what it scores. And calipers and pop cans and sticky notes both ways ended up with the same score. So what that shows you is that if you don't have calipers, there's other ways that you can score your skull. You can go back and watch that other video that I did if you want to find out the other way. Just to find out what your score is. You know, Pope and Young minimum's 18 inches. Boone and Crockett, I believe, is 21. Those are the two, you know, ones that you're looking at. Maybe you're just curious to find out what it scores, or maybe you're just seeing, hey, is it close enough? Then I do want to put it in the book if it's close enough or over. You know, it'll give you a good judge. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope this helps you out if you're going to measure your skull yourself to try to find out. And do me a favor, hit that subscribe button and come on back, and we'll have some other videos with hunting tips, hunting videos and stuff like that. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching.